Gamification is greatly influenced by marketers way back 1896, when they introduced loyalty programs to customers at SNH, Green Stamps. Fast forward 77 years later, Charles Conrad found a consultant firm called The Game of Work and brings feedback loops found in sports into the workplace. It is basically a strategy that helps corporations to increase job enjoyment while gaining increased productivity in the workplace. Then, the first multi-user virtual world game was created by Roy Trubshaw at Essex University called Mud One in 1979. The virtual world existing was truly addicting, bringing the users into a realm that simulates a role-playing game. The following year, Thomas Malone published a book studied how computer games intrinsically motivates learners. He questioned why computer games are captivating and how can the features of computer games be used in learning. Gamification in the marketing industry continues for the next 3 years, with American Airlines launching frequent flyer program and Holiday Inn launching their first hotel loyalty program as marketing strategies to attract more customers. The perks and benefits of these loyalty programs were extended to car rental companies to keep their customers motivated to get their services. The idea is for them to provide a stimulus that intrinsically motivates customers to earn more points to get freebies. Then the 90s came. 30% of American households owns an NES or Nintendo Entertainment System. 6 years later, Richard Bartle published Who Plays MUAs or Multi-User Adventures. He divides gamers as achievers, killers, socializers, and explorers. By the time the new millennium approached, in 2002, serious gaming initiatives are increasing. Role-playing games, strategy, adventure, and simulation games emerged.
Hi, I'm Kevin Richardson. I'm the winner of Volkswagen's Fun Theory Award. My idea was the speed camera lottery. Could we get people to obey the speed limit for fun? I really believe that fun can change human behavior for the better, and I was really thrilled to see that my idea, which started as a scribble submitted into this competition, might even become reality. The speed camera lottery would do two things. One, it would photograph speeders, give them a citation, and that money goes in a pot. But if you're obeying the law, your picture will also get snapped. You'll be entered into a lottery and win some of that money from those speeders.
Jag kör alltid lagligt, men det är tveksamt om jag vinner.
Det är ju bra positiva grejer det där. Kör lagligt och tjäna deg, det är perfekt.
Principle common to the simulation of game-based learning literature are scaffolding, problem-solving, exploration, context, interaction, agency, learning through doing. Pause to reflect. Learning through failure, adaptivity, character, and engagement. These principles were the core of these emerging game-based websites created. With gaining popularity of gamification, the first summit was held in San Francisco in 2010. It featured experts in the art of making things that are normally boring, such as filling out surveys, shopping, or visiting websites, more interesting by adding game-like features. 2 years after, 45,000 people enrolled in Professor Kevin Warbach's online gamification course on Coursera. The course taught learners the mechanism of gamification and effective use of non-game problems, such as business and social impact challenges. In the same year, Mozilla launched Open Badges for Skills Learned Online. It communicates skills and achievements by providing visual symbols of accomplishments with verifiable data and evidence that can be shared across the web. According to Gartner's Hype Cycle prediction in 2012, 70% of Global 2000 organizations will have at least one gamified application by 2014. Though with its widespread use, during this time, gamified applications must be evaluated to meet business objectives to improve poor designs. However, M2 Research predicts that gamification will be a $2.8 billion industry by 2016. The game thinking and mechanics truly engages users. So where do we go from here? With gamification as a mainstream strategy for businesses and consumers, it has found its way to groundbreaking science projects, learning environments, and such. When done correctly, gamification will produce phenomenal results and will be a mainstay cultural force for a long time. The crazy hype around gamification is over. More and more people are actively looking to invest into gamification and educate themselves to evaluate if gamification may work for their company rather than just keeping up with a hip trend. Companies are now introducing gamification as a part of a larger digital transformation and innovation program. Gamification is all over social media and mobile apps. Most of customer-facing apps will have a game element to engage users that creates a loyalty or to entice them to try something new. It becomes a fun marketing gimmick that aim for a loyal community of customers. Learning apps provide learners badges or points advancements such as Khan Academy that rewards their learners points and rewards skill achievement. Gamification to keep employees engaged and feeling like they're a part of a team is critical for retention. Human Resource uses gamification to promote positive culture by rewarding employees. The goal is to create a rewarding and attentive workforce, driving desirable employee behavior and improve efficiency. Entertainment in the hospitality industry provides their guests on-location VR experiences. Marriott introduced Samsung VR gear in some of their hotel rooms. By using their gears, where guests can visit and view unique panoramas around the world, they can also market their hotels as marketing tactics. Some gamification in augmented reality is the Pokemon Go for younger audiences. It is engaging and fun as it uses smartphone's camera to overlay Pokemon onto a view of the real world and get points and achievement badges. With the rise of gamification technology, a friendly competition and collaboration in different contexts become prominent. The introduction of game elements and gameful experiences in the design of learning process supports deeper learning and addresses behavior of students' self-direction, creativity, and retention. What is the future of gamification? Here's a unique insight about its future on how gamification will evolve and develop in the coming years ahead. How we currently understand about gamification will not evolve, but becomes outdated. We must not let this happen because the surge of technological innovation will lead to new expressions of gamification. To understand how the future looks like for gamification, perspectives from experts will help us paint a picture of what's ahead in the arena of gamification. Craig Mills, who is a learning manager, immersed his company, Game Learning Zone, to a gamified learning management system to provide the most engaging experience to their gamers. As learners complete their learning, they advance competencies linked to a specific content completion targets, leading to leveling up. And it is certain that skill-specific badges and recognition system will continue over time. According to Marigo Raftopoulos, the future of gamification will be a strategic management tool. It will be more about how we think, collaborate, and how we co-create different ways of learning and building community. Strategically focused gamification promotes human agency and empowers them to change the system. One example is the Fun Theory, led by Volkswagen. They started this gamification to change human behavior in terms of recycling. These are just a few directions that gamification is moving towards. It is still a staple of the marketing industry, but as more and more individuals use gamification in their learning, personal use in other industries, human empowerment becomes more significant in the world of gamification.